Welcome to World of Fusion 360. In this video, we'll explore a little about generative design in Fusion 360. Not a little, I hope much more than that. Now, watch this. We're going to generate design for brake pedal. Without further ado, let's get started. So, here we are. Before switching to generative workspace, you may have to focus on two areas. One at the pivot, based on which pedal rotates, and the area at which we apply force. These are the main areas which we have to focus, and the rest is for reference only. Let's look at the properties for this pedal. The mass of this pedal is 229 grams approximately. The material is steel by default, but we are going to manufacture it with titanium. Let's go and change the physical material for this pedal, though it doesn't affect the generative design. In metal, scroll down. And select titanium. Now, switch to generative design. Let's have a look at from the top. You can learn all about generative design by clicking on toggle learning panel if you want. And steady, we have new generative steady, but we have one already here by default. Coming to steady settings, what we want to focus is here actually. Increase the resolution for better results, just a bit, and click OK. Moving forward, click on Edit Model. Under Model Components, inside Bodies, we are having only one. For generative study, we must have more than one body. That is for preserves and obstacles. Create a sketch on the pedal face and select the face. Then press P to project the face, finish the sketch, and select the sketch to extrude. Select the opposite face as distance. Change the operation to new body. Let's create another sketch on this face and project the circle again by pressing P. Perfect. Opposite the circle 2mm inside. And finish the sketch. Select the profile, not inside, and extrude the other side. Change the operation to new body and click OK. Now we have to tell the software that not to fill the material where we don't want, particularly at the connectors such as bolts and nuts. For this model, a bolt will be at the pivot. Click on connector obstacle and select the inside edge. You'll observe that a shaft through hole is passing to the other side. Just by adjusting the parameters inside the dialog box, you can get our connector. If you observe here, it had created a shaft diameter as 12 mm. I wanna change it to 11.85 mm. Now click on bolt head. Enable bolt head on both sides after the shaft length from 24 to 4 mm. Similarly, head length as 10 mm. Let's go ahead and finish the edit model. Select preserve in here and choose the geometry that we must need. Select the pivot and the body on which force acts. We have already selected obstacles when we have created a connected obstacle. Coming to the structural constraints, let's hide the obstacle geometry so that we can see pivot face to be fixed. In practical world, we apply force on the pedal and the pivot rotates only in one axis, demanding to a fix. This is only for some extent because of the spring. At extreme point, it won't rotate. We are considering that extreme point and fixing this face in all directions. Apply force on the face. And let the amount of force be 2000 newtons. here comes objectives for our requirement. We can choose minimize mass or maximize stiffness by varying limits such as safety factor and mass factor. For now, I'm going with minimize mass. Coming to manufacturing, unrestricted will allow the machine to generate an organic design. With additive, we can 3D print the part by overhang angle and minimum thickness parameters as base. In milling, we have 3 axis, 2.5 axis and even 5 axis. This design is not supported from 2.5 axis machining. Let's add 5 axis machining by clicking plus sign in here. In 3 axis, switch the tool direction to Y positive and click OK. Choose the material for steady. We have many materials in here. I'm adding titanium and Inconel 625. Oh, we got a warning here. It's telling that the head diameter is large. This is because the model is inclined. Let's go back to the design workspace and rotate the model to fix it. Select body and press M for move and rotate. Let's rotate this body to 45 degrees and switch back to generative workspace. Now observe that everything seems perfect. Orient the gravity about 90 degrees by changing the direction type. Let's have a preview. The preview is not what I want actually. I want a material to be added in this direction. Let's go back and edit the model. And in combine, change operation to cut. Set the main body as target. Pivot and pedal as tool bodies. Check the key tools and click OK. Edit the starting shape and select the main body. This warning is because we've hided the bodies in design workspace. There is no problem with that, but I want to view them back now. Generate the design. It takes some time to generate output. We'll explore the generated results in the next video. Click on the link in the description to watch it or from the info in here. Hope I'll catch you in the next video. Thank you for watching.